Welcome everybody to our next installment of Golden Craft Run. We're here at Bottle Logic Brewing. We got six awesome beers we're gonna drink today. I'm gonna introduce you to them right now. First one we got on the palate is the Jewel Thief Blueberry. Quite acidic looking, very light, just really acidic off the top, touches the tongue, then it goes into blueberry, and then it goes back to really sour, like extremely sour, like Warheads sour. Second one on our palate is the Smoldering Celestial. Look at that color, it's like that nice amber color. Tell your fortune in there, whatever you want to do. Definitely gonna rank higher than the blueberry. Getting some malty hints there. Really like deep sud. Oh man, this is spectacular. It's really like creamy. Definitely gonna rank higher than the blueberry. Up next is the Recursion West Coast IPA. It's like a lighter IPA. Smells good. It's really hoppy. Obviously, weedy and hoppy at the same time. There's about the same amount of wheat as there is hops in it. From the depths of the earth comes the Catacomb Porter. Really dark. I can't even see through this bad boy. It is dead black. Tastes barrel-aged. Might be. That would go good with bacon. Definitely. This is a bacon beer. Not that it tastes like bacon. It would just go really good with bacon. Mostly because probably the coffee. I like coffee and bacon, so... It's time to consider the coconut with this one, ladies and gentlemen. So that has like a coffee tinge. I like that. Oh man, it is sweet, let me tell you. Kind of reminds me of the Sticky Monkey release from Firestone Walker. $17 a bottle, but this is not as expensive, just as delicious. And the last one is Fundamental Observation. Oh my god, this is an Imperial Stout, and it is just off-the-nose delicious. Whoa, that is an in-depth Imperial Stout. There's not too many beers out there with this much flavor, I think, as far as Imperial Stouts go. Like, I could just sip on this like whiskey, dude. Like, this is good. So right now we're going to do a quick review of these beers. 1 to 6. 1 being the most favorite, 6 being the least, just on my personal preference, alright? So, no hard feelings here, Bottle Logic. So for number 6 we got the Recursion IPA. You know, it's an IPA, it's West Coast IPA. A lot of these breweries in this area play this kind of card, and it usually works out for them. In this case, it's just another beer on the ballot, nothing special. At number 5 we have the Blueberry Jewel Thief. Now you guys know from watching the shows from before, I'm not that much of a sour guy. It rated higher than it usually does, which is good for this beer because I love blueberries. So for 4th place, we got the Catacomb Porter. Those coffee notes though, man, they hit you, man. It's like I'm drinking coffee straight up. It's good though. I mean, if you like coffee porters, this is probably your number 1. For number 3 is a Celestial Amber. Oh my god. It's got nice malty flavor, and it doesn't stop kicking that malty flavor. I'm still tasting it from that last. This has a lot of flavor. It's good. So, for 2nd place, we got Consider the Coconut Porter. It's sweet, it's delicious. I would suggest this for a dessert beer. End the night on this beer, baby, because it's going to take you home nice and sweet. Weighing in at a heavy 13.2 ABV, we got our winner, the Fundamental Observation, baby. It's everything you want in Imperial Stout. It's coffee, it's malty, so many flavors, and it's so easy to drink that I can literally sip on this the whole night and have a great time. Thank you for watching this episode of Golden Craft Run. We'll catch you at the next brewery. To the craft.
That's it. And then the beer's really good.